today we're going to look at this eye solution from World War II. I actually got this on eBay. It came in the original package unopened. So of course I opened it. It came with the dropper and a little cardboard tube to protect the glass dropper. The rubber on the dropper doesn't squeeze anymore. It's hardened now. I opened the bottle and man, this stuff stinks. So let's get into the story. In 1860, pharmacist John Wyeth and his younger brother Frank opened a drugstore with a small research lab at 1412 Walnut Street in Philadelphia, called John Wyeth and Brother Chemists. In 1862, they started manufacturing large quantities of commonly ordered medicines in advance, so they could be on hand and ready for customers to use rather than have them made to order. Making such medicines in large quantities also allowed them to sell them at a reduced rate, which undercut their competitors. They really became successful during the Civil War when they began supplying medicines and beef extract to the Union Army in the field. In 1872, Henry Bowers, an employee of Wyeth, had invented a machine that could mass produce pills or tablets that had pre-measured dosages. It was one of the very first tablet machines invented in the United States. Unfortunately, I can't find any pictures. This enabled the mass production of medicines with unprecedented precision and speed. The Wyeth brothers won multiple awards at the Centennial Exhibition for this. The Centennial Exhibition was this huge fair where millions of people came from 37 different countries to come show off their inventions or new ideas, lots of entertainment, just a really huge production. In 1883, Wyeth opened its first facility in Montreal, Canada, and began researching and producing vaccines. 6 years later, a fire destroyed the brothers' original Walnut Street store, and they decided to sell the retail business because they were more interested in the mass production. And they opened this new shop at 11th and Washington. In 1901, they introduced chocolate-covered pills. That's awesome. John Wyeth died of pneumonia in 1907, and his only son, Stuart, became the company's president. The Whitehall building in downtown Manhattan became the corporation's first headquarters. Sales really took off due to Wyeth's Colinos brand of toothpaste. When Stuart Wyeth died in 1929, he decided to leave the controlling interest of the company to Harvard University. The following year, in 1930, Wyeth purchased Anacin, a headache medicine, which quickly became one of the company's most successful products. 1 year later, in 1931, Harvard sold Wyeth to American Home Products for $2.9 million. In 1935, a guy named Alvin Brush became CEO of the organization and served for 30 years. Under his leadership, 34 new companies were acquired in 15 years. So now we're up to the time frame of my bottle. In 1941, the U.S. entered World War II, and American Home Products shipped many necessary wartime drugs towards the war effort. Wyeth was later rewarded for its contribution to the war effort. It was during this time that Wyeth actually launched its penicillin research facility. My bottle was manufactured in 1935. There's a date stamp at the bottom. This is an Owen stamp, and the 5 means 1935. After the 1930s, Owens added 2-digit dates. This eye solution was to treat lewisite in the eyes. It's meant to be used on the battlefield. According to this War Department book, printed in 1944, lewisite is used in chemical warfare. It's oily, colorless, and it has a faint scent of geraniums. It's more volatile and less persistent than mustard, making it more effective in colder weather. Lewisite acts more rapidly and produces more severe skin lesions than mustard. It blisters just as mustard does, and it fills with an opaque yellow fluid. Lewisite, like mustard, penetrates fabric and rubber, making it dangerous to wear clothing or rubber gloves once they've been contaminated. Lewisite, like mustard, injures the eyes, skin, and respiratory tract, and produces systemic effects. In contrast to mustard liquid, lewisite causes stinging pain in 10 to 30 seconds, which increases in severity. The vapor, though, is not that dangerous. Liquid lewisite instantly produces a searing of the cornea, like an acid burn at the point of contact, and intensifies the longer it penetrates. It says, all eye injuries are susceptible to secondary infections. Mild contact with lewisite may heal in a few days, but eyes contaminated with lewisite require immediate treatment with BAL solution, which stands for British Anti-Lewisite. If BAL is used in the first minute of contamination, the eye usually recovers in a few days. If it's used within the first 10 minutes, the eye may take weeks to recover, but it will most likely leave permanent damage. If it's used within the first 30 minutes, it will have very little effect. The instructions specifically say do not treat the eye more than once. It also states that if you put BAL solution into a normal eye, it will cause sharp stinging pain, that you should only use it in the case of lewisite in the eye, which actually has the opposite effect. It neutralizes the pain in the eye caused by the lewisite. That's pretty intense. So anyway, Wyeth is still around. It's been shuffled around a few times, but there are still products floating around with Wyeth's name on it. It's owned by Pfizer right now. There are lots of antique glass bottles out there, many shapes and colors embossed with either Wyeth or John Wyeth and Brother. And that's about all I have for this one. Hope you enjoyed learning something new. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.